This is Jazz Casual, and I'm Ralph Gleason. And we've brought into the studio today the great Brazilian guitarist Bola Seta and the jazz musician Vince Guaraldi and his trio to try to show you some of the ways in which jazz music has crept around the world and has received contributions from other musics. We're also all in our shirt sleeves today as an attempt to shatter the stereotype of San Francisco summer weather. It's not cool, it's hot as a pistol here. And we hope the music isn't really too cool for you, but also time to time bubbles along. One of the things that's been fascinating about jazz in recent years has been the way in which it has spread throughout the world. And particularly in Brazil, the native jazz musicians, the native Brazilians, have contributed something of their own to American jazz music. Now, they heard jazz music first by way of records, by way of radio broadcasts, and after World War II, by virtue of the traveling units such as the Tommy Dorsey Band and Charlie Byrd and some State Department people that went through there. These had a great influence on Brazilian musicians, and they had took up some of the jazz styles and some of the jazz way of playing and added it to their own music, and in turn they took their own music and put it into the jazz language. The net result of this has been something that has been called bossa nova, which has been popularized and commercialized almost beyond belief in the last couple of years. But nevertheless, it still is a very valid thing when it's played by the really valid musicians such as Bola Seta. I hope that we're going to be able this afternoon to show some of the things that have influenced him. He, for instance, in his early days as a musician, he became enamored of the guitar playing of an American jazz guitarist, George Van Epps. And for a number of months, he practiced and practiced until he memorized all of George Van Epps' tunes from a particular album and was able to do them himself. Now, Bola Seta has been in this country for some years. He and Vince Guaraldi have made an album together, and they're going to do this afternoon some of the things that they've done in that album to show how the American jazz musicians and the Brazilian jazz musicians meet on a common ground. Take a stroll over to Bola and see if we can talk him into this now. I wonder if you could show us some of these things that George Van Epps, the American jazz guitarist, the influence that he had on you, play one of his tunes, perhaps?
Yes.
And then maybe some other tune after that that shows the way in which you approach a standard American jazz tune. I think we discussed doing El Bongo, which is a Van Epps tune, and then after that, one of Dizzy Gillespie's tunes, Tour de Force?
Tour de Force.
Yeah. All right, go. Thank you. You do all that with no amplification and no picks and just your fingers.
Yeah.
Well, you and Vince, you're going to do tunes together now with the Vince Guaraldi Trio with Fred Marshall on bass and Jerry Granelli on drums. So what are you going to do, Vince?
I'm going to do two originals. The first one I wrote, it's called Star Song.
Is this in the bossa nova style?
This is, yeah. It's my own composition. I kind of try to, I like the bossa nova music.
Yeah.
Like to try to write some things for it, and this is one of them. And the other one Bola wrote, it's called Mombasa, which is a little bit of bossa nova and a little bit of mambo. And it's kind of wild. It comes out wild.
That's good.